The Bible never guarantees that the evil day will not come. The Bible only guarantees that if the armor of God is upon you, you will stand against the evil day. Loins girt about with truth means that you hold yourself up by God's standard. The feet is your point of interaction with the earth. Scripture says, how beautiful are the feet of them that bring good tidings. It means that every time the evangelical is referred to in scripture, it is tied to the feet. The propelling power to go anywhere must be prepared for. What gives you the confidence in the day when they are attacking your job is the person who sent you there and what you went there to do. If it was the preparation to preach that took you there, until it is done, no man can uproot you. It means our excitement to enter any place is the opportunity that God has in the place, not the salary place. He doesn't leave the 99 because he loves you more than he loves the 99. It's because the 99 have sense. They are living in culture. That means the 99 do not need the presence of the shepherd to keep themselves in order. No shepherd will leave the 99 if he comes back and 16 are lost. I am thankful that he leaves the 99. Because when I stray, I need him to leave the 99. But I will rather belong. So don't glory in the fact that you were lost and he found you. Give him glory, but don't glory in it. Because for me to stray will mean that I did not learn the culture of the house enough to exalt it to be kept in the house. And it's because the shepherd knows that the 99 have got a culture within themselves that make that no matter how long he goes looking for that one, by the time he returns, the 99 will still be safe. Listen to me very carefully. Every time Satan cannot reach your life, what he does is he changes your environment. Now you understand why you have to follow certain things religiously. So you don't use religion to replace life, but you need religion to sustain life. So I guard my heart with all diligence. You see, the diligence that is required there is religious. So I will not play secular music in my house. Religious. And yet, it is because I want to consciously protect the environment around which my life type thrives. You must take up the responsibility to culture the environment around which your life type thrives.
Save my soul. I want to live eternal life. God, save my soul.
Why God is working all the faith, he's working in you, is so that you can apprehend what is called the salvation of your soul. But understand that the salvation of the soul within this context is not the salvation you received at repentance. The salvation of the soul within this context is the place where you arrive, where your mind is totally captured, so that when the Bible says guard your heart with all diligence because out of it flows out the issues of life, it means that at that place you have set a full garrison around your mind so that only that which is godly can thrive. Your attention is supposed to be on two things as far as your guarding is concerned. Guarding. Boundary. Every time I turn like this, I must be tending. Every time I turn like this, I must be keeping. My relationship with the garden is tending. So I must find every good gift of God that is in me, that is in Christ Jesus, and encourage it, fan it to flame, strengthen it. I must find the things that God calls wisdom that the world calls foolishness. And tend it. Those ones, you don't even wait for the leading of the Spirit. You set up a structure for your life to tend those kind of things. My second responsibility is to keep it, to guard the boundaries. That means everything within my boundaries must be instructed. Start your instruction from your internal boundaries. I don't have the luxury of running around with a troubled soul. Every time I do, something is breaking my boundaries. What I'm denying is the salvation of my soul. You are not a victim. Undo it from your mind. You might not have control over a circumstance, but you have the control over yourself. It means let your soul not have the right to wake up in the morning and have a mood. So the central point of all prophecy is obedience. And that obedience is not just responding to what God said. Is entering into a life structure that consistently is ready to obey God. Obedience is structuring your life such that you don't have a choice when God speaks. So the central essence of obedience is not just getting the job done. It's being in a heart structure that is always ready. It means that you don't go to be used by the master because the master has need of you. You keep yourself in a state where whenever the master has need, you are ready.